As the Patuxent flows, so does Calvert County. The gateway for commerce, travel, and most of its history till the 20th century, access to the river has been the lifeblood of most communities in the county. Lower Marlboro was no exception. By 1750, Lower Marlboro had grown into the chief port for tobacco in the northern part of the county, and had begun to service river traffic with its first wharf, which was built in 1750. Lower Marlboro also served the British as an official port of entry, a place where royal tariffs were collected as well as a tobacco inspection center. During the American War of Independence and the War of 1812, the wharf was used as a landing for British warships and as an entry point for the British to sack the town and set fire to tobacco warehouses on June 16, 1814. Recent research revealed that 13 enslaved persons escaped to freedom, taking refuge on one of the British vessels that came into Lower Marlboro in July of 1814. The British troops, accompanied by Colonial Marines, a unit made up of former slaves, burned the tobacco warehouses. The British then took the enslaved families to safety on their boats. Most of the 13 later showed up on documents as free people in Nova Scotia. In 1821, Captain George Weems, founder of the Weems Steamboat Company, introduced the first steamboat to Calvert County by bringing his ship, the Eagle, up the Patuxent River. The Weems steamboats plied the river until 1905, when it was sold to the Maryland, Delaware, and Virginia Railway Company. Traffic eventually decreased and finally stopped due to the river filling with silt being declared undredgeable and too shallow to allow steamboat travel on the river. When viable, the steamboats were the preferred method of travel and shipping on the river. In January of 1885, the Patuxent was covered with thick ice from shore to shore. All navigation was suspended. The local paper reported that the coming of the steamboat is an event that brightens the week at Marlboro, and its prolonged absence is always a topic for discussion. Mason L. Weems, son of George Weems, acquired the wharf property in 1859 and promptly constructed an L-shaped wharf, which was wide enough to permit carts on the deck. Two warehouses were also built at the end of the wharf. Weems steamboats called on the wharf at least three times a week during the busy peach harvesting season. The residents of Lower Marlboro often looked at the steamboats as social outlets. The steamboat line recognized this and scheduled a popular series of weekend excursions to Baltimore. Many social organizations use steamboats for fundraising cruises. Listen to lifelong Calvert County resident Dale Norfolk talk about his friend, the legendary Hugh Jackson, and his adventures at the wharf.
Mr. Hugh Jackson ran the sawmill, and he pretty much sawed all the lumber, tobacco sticks, framing, everything you can think of in the north end of the county. As the story goes, two things that Mr. Jackson did down at Lower Marlboro at the old pier, there used to be an old steamboat came up in there. And there was it's deep water, but they always said it was only a little bit of distance between the bottom of the boat and the river bottom. And they always said that Mr. Jackson dove off of the pier at Lower Marlboro and swam down under the steamboat, came back up on the other side, which he did on a bet. Mr. Hugh Jackson took a Model T Ford when this river froze, and he put his Model T on the river at Lower Marlboro, and it's either six or eight farmers. They tied a rope to it, and they all had ice skates on, and he drove all the way down to Benedict, down here, and all the way back up, pulling all these guys on skates.
By 1938, all steamboat activity on the Patuxent was coming to a close, and commerce on the river faltered. The wharf at Lower Marlboro, once the premier port on the upper Patuxent, is now owned by the county government and is accessible to the public, where it is primarily used for recreation and fishing.